I'm using ChatGPT to create an evolution game with Unity's AI system. First, let me explain the idea. I told ChatGPT that I wanted it to help me create an evolution simulator. The player will be able to spawn in animals such as deers and wolves, and environmental elements like trees. Also, it is worth noting that I am somewhat well-versed in game dev. I've created many, many successful projects that have worked perfectly with no bugs whatsoever. So, today we will be testing the limits of ChatGPT, and not myself. After a bit of finagling, ChatGPT gave me a step-by-step list of instructions that I am going to follow. The first step is to build the map. Hopping into Unity, I started by adding a terrain object to my scene. I played around with the texture, height, and tree settings for an hour, but ultimately I realized that making my own terrain was pointless, seeing as ChatGPT is going to make the map randomized. Because of this, I asked ChatGPT to create a random terrain generator using Perlinoise. For those of you who don't know what Perlinoise is, here's a quick explanation. Perlinoise is basically this algorithm that generates random numbers from 0 to 1. These numbers are then converted into noise, or life values, which represent the height map used to generate the terrain. The special thing about Perlinoise is that the numbers generated are pseudo-random, meaning that the changes are gradual. For example, you might go from 0.01 to 0.02, but you will never jump from 0.1 to 0.7. This allows for smooth randomized terrain generation. Using Perlinoise, I was able to wrestle ChatGPT into creating me a working generation script. Like I said, using Perlinoise, I was able to wrestle ChatGPT into creating me a working generation script. I also asked ChatGPT to add random objects to the map generation script and a randomized button, which both definitely worked on the first try. Seeing as I was generating such beautiful maps, I decided that the player needs to be able to view these maps inside of the game. So I asked ChatGPT to make me a camera movement script. Wow, oh my god, sensational. Dang, I am totally gonna subscribe to that Brainlocks guy. Now that the camera script is sorted, it's time for one of the biggest additions to the game, animals. Don't judge me, I'll probably fix the models later in the video. I actually don't know, I'm recording this live and breaking the fourth wall at the same time, so we'll see. Anyways, to start, I added an animal class and two subclasses, the deer and the wolf. Each animal has simple characteristics such as health, stamina, speed, hunger, is carnivore, body part size, etc. The subclasses have their own specific variables such as attack damage for the wolves and food detection for the deer. After getting the class framework in place, I made a spawning menu so that players could spawn in animals. But there's a slight problem. Currently our animals are really, really dumb. Like pouring the milk before the cereal levels of dumb. So let's give them a brain. To start, I added AI movement. Something about this doesn't look right. After hours of fiddling with ChatGPT, I wasn't able to solve this issue. But I performed this little known tactic called the yank and twist, and I was able to get the code to work properly. Or so I thought. The Unity gods must have been looking the other way that day because, well, just roll them on dodge. Anyways, after hours of fiddling about, the animals are finally moving around, and they're all nice and peaceful. Psych? What did you think this was? Some peaceful Animal Crossing Stardew Valley video? Nah. The wolves immediately started chasing after the deer, but there was one problem. The wolves couldn't attack the deer. So, it's time to add an attack functionality for the wolves. To do this, I added a detection radius to the wolves. When a deer enters this radius, this fancy script is triggered, and voila! The attack animation is triggered, and overpopulation is solved. Next, I had ChatGPT make it so that every animal's stats are randomized when they spawn in. This I hope will give the game more variety and replayability. I also added a UI element to the screen which allows players to adjust the values of spawned in animals. This I hope will promote custom gameplay. Now, keen viewers might have noticed the two major flaws in the game right now. Firstly, the environment looks awful. It's super boring and it has no life to it. Secondly, the game isn't fair at all. The deer just get murked by the wolves every single time and they stand no chance whatsoever. So let's fix these issues. To solve the first issue, I added more animals to the game. I added a rabbit and a fox. And don't worry, the These are definitely not reskinned versions of the deer and the wolf.
For sure.
I then asked ChatGPT for websites with free 3D models. After a bit of finagling, I was able to find this amazing website, which I will link in the description. Adding in these trees and rocks truly gave the game life, in my opinion. To solve the second issue, I did two things. First, I gave the deer and rabbit a food source, using one of Kinney's free models. Second, I gave the wolves and foxes a stamina debuff to simulate the short bursts of energy that these animals get in comparison to their deer and rabbit counterparts. My hope is that the high stamina prey will be able to survive and pass their genes on to the next generation. And oh yeah, did I mention? Evolution is now properly in the game.
Wait, that's the wrong clip. I just want to take a second to recognize how crazy ChatGPT is. I was able to create this script that should have taken days to create in a couple of hours. Anyways, here's how it works. Surviving animals randomly breed with other non-gender specific animals of the same type every 3 to 5 minutes and create offspring. These offspring then take 3 to 5 minutes to grow up before they can reproduce. The offspring have a 50-50 chance of inheriting the traits from each of its parents. When inheriting traits, these traits are then multiplied by a factor of 0.5 to 1.5, which is chosen randomly by the program.
And now the game is almost done. All it needs is some finishing touches like a pause menu, some AI music, some UI changes, and the hand of God.
Wait, did you see the hand of God?
Oh yeah, I forgot to mention, I decided to add God powers to the game last minute. So yeah guys, this is my 1 week challenge. There are definitely some more parts to the game that I'd like to add, so please let me know if I should do a part 2 where I fix all the shortcuts I had to take.